All right, we are back. Cape of Stranglethorn. Time to see what's going on. Maybe we'll finish the zone. Maybe we won't. I have no idea. I don't even know what I have for quests. I have two. Getting in with the blood sail and up to snuff. Oh, the up to snuff, I remember. I forgot to pick it up, and I have to go kill everything that I was killing before. Well, let's do that first. It'll be a lot easier to pick up and complete quests this time around because the New Year's Eve holiday is done. So the guards are back in full force, so you can't just freely kill NPCs. I ran into a problem with that in the last episode. It was kind of annoying. I didn't expect it. That's why it was most annoying. I had to wait for respawns a couple times. Luckily, they seemed to be fairly quick. Let's go to chapters. We have one of four chapters to go. So let's get right into it. Get all this snuff and get on our merry way. What's really nice about doing these episodes so quick now and putting them up in YouTube in almost real time is I don't have the lag of, well, how do I play this class? What are my keybinds? What am I doing wrong? Because there's always a little bit of that. If I don't play something for like 3-4 weeks, I lose track of what my keybinds were. I screw up rotations. I don't use the right things. But I just played this guy a couple days ago. We're starting the episode as a level 42. We'll see what level we get to. Hopefully level 44, maybe 45. We'll have to see how it goes. Wow. So much damage. How did you incapacitate me that fast? That doesn't make any sense. Whatever. The good news is there's no alliance around. All right, let's go over here. Let's get sweeping strikes incapacitated. Come here, come here. All right, here we go. Almost in execute range. I love sweeping strikes plus execute. Oh, you know what? I should really be using impending victory. There we go. Get some health right away. Now I can use it again on this guy. My war stomp is faster than your, what was it? A fireball? Yeah. Where are we in snuff? We're still 10 of 15. That's surprising, actually. Boy, what's the drop rate? I got 10 pretty quick, and now it's been nothing. This is weird. So those mobs incapacitate really fast. Two stacks of overpower. Oh, there's another guy here. So we're just going to do some sweeping strikes. We're going to get, I'm incapacitated. We're going to get our 100% parry going on. We're going to heal ourselves. Easy mode. Absolute easy mode. And we got all our snuff. Of course we did. So back to Booty Bay. I'm going to hearth right away. The Salty Sailor Tavern. That is the correct place. So I'm going to hearth. Save a little time. And see how much I have left in the cape. I've already discovered it all. So I've done the gorillas. I've done the ZG part. I wonder what's left. Looks like he's upstairs. Where is he? Ah, there he is. Blackwater Raiders. Some snuff. All right, Bustling Booty Bay. So that's done. Now I have Bloodsail and Brashtide and a Pirate's Life for you. Now I've already done some Pirate's Quest. So we'll have to see what's next. What is this giant? Keep an eye out. All right, well, let's go see what that is. This is not a quest I want to do, if I recall correctly. This is Western Plague Lands. We don't want to go there. But I do want to see what this other quest is. Is it in here? I can't fit in there. I can't fit in this door. Jeez. No, it's not in here. Is it in here? No? How about up here? No. Oh, a cow. Hey, bossy. Trying to figure out how to get back downstairs. The only pet you'll ever need in World War. Oh, there he is right there. Well, I figured out where he was, and I just have to get back up there.
Greetings.
Avast, who goes there? Retrieve Dizzy's Eye from the Bloodsail Buccaneers. Okay, so we have to go there again. I did a very poor job of planning out this zone, and by planning out this zone, I mean not planning out this zone at all, because I didn't. And it shows. I'm useless without my special enchanted eye. Bad enough to have lost my eyes in battle in the first place, but by some stroke of luck, we docked in Menethil, and a traveling wizard enchanted a special glass eye that I might see again. Last night, I ended up getting jumped by some Bloodsail Buccaneers on my way out. Oh, crap. I'm rooted. I can't do anything. There we go. Jeez. I can't wait to kill that thing that's just sitting back there casting on me. Somebody else attacking me now? I'm rooted. I can't do anything. Can I throw? Yep, I can throw for 32. Nice. I like that combo. Oh, I haven't killed him yet. That's why I can't do impending victory. Man, I gotta go away. Actually, no. Yep, I gotta go away. Too many roots, too many, I'm gonna die. There's just nothing I can do. Ugh. Anyway. So I was reading the quest and I wasn't even running the right way. I thought I was running towards the coast, but it turns out I was running through like 5 different mobs. So don't do that. Where did I turn? Oh, down here. I turned left for some reason instead of going straight. Ah, I went left instead of right. Good one. All right, revenge time. Being rooted as melee kind of sucks, because you literally can't do anything. Even though it's not on the map, these guys do drop the eye, which is why I'm here. Ugh. Are you kidding? Oh, I wish I could get out of Root. Come here. Meow. Oh, I got you. Nice. Two stacks of overpower. Love it. What is this called again? Mortal Strike. I still haven't gotten the eye. Interesting. This should get him. Ooh, ouch. See you, buddy. All right, so, oh, I got one more guy. Maybe he'll drop it, maybe he won't. We'll find out. What's the drop rate on this eye? Man. Well, I'm gonna go back to the other side. Report to Yancey Grilson at the waterfall north of Booty Bay. So that's up there, okay. Oh, please don't tell me there's Alliance here now. We got one. One is all you need, right? Maybe? Hey, come here. Nope, I need more than one. So I ordered my new mouse pad today. It should come on Monday. Because I can't find it in stock anywhere locally, so I just ordered it from Amazon. The one I have, I really, really like, but it's plastic. And I don't like a plastic hardcover mouse pad. I thought I'd try it out, because it's easier to clean, it's easier to maintain, it probably lasts longer as well, but I don't like it. I feel like my mouse just moves on its own. And if I move it just a little bit, it slides all the way across. It's crazy. So I got the same mouse pad, only I'm getting the cloth version of it. Wow. Nobody here. Oh, there's an Alliance. Well, at least I take both of them. Didn't drop what I needed. Oh, wait. Yes, it did. I didn't even see it. When did I get it? Just now. Ah. Must have been a little lag on the loot, because I looked and it still said O of 1, but then it switched. Like, must have been right after. So let's see if this is the last time I have to come to this beach to do quests. I'm guessing I have to go down to the ships to kill some captains, if that's still in the game. Maybe it's not. I don't know. We'll find out. Episode 16 of this playthrough already. And episode 13 is going up tomorrow. So I am pretty much in real time in terms of how long it takes to post-process an episode and then render it. It takes about 24 hours to render. Rendering is generally the slowest part. I can usually do processing of an episode in about 3 hours, 2 hours, depending on the length of the episode. But rendering, that's the time sink. That's literally where I just hit go. And the computer renders the episode for anywhere from 28 to 48 hours, depending on how long it is. So realistically, I'm looking at posting episodes 4 days or so, 4 to 5 days after they air on Twitch. which is a good schedule to have, I think. We'll see what happens in Classic with how I'm able to keep up.
What can I do for you? Go with honor, Freddy.
No, not even a follow-up quest. No way. Really? Okay. Is there any quest that I'm missing? No. That's the one for Western Plaguelands, which I don't want to do. Okay. Well, I'm just going to go out to the waterfall, see what the next quest is, and figure out when I'm going to get... Well, actually, I don't know which one I'm doing now. It's either A Pirate's Life for You or Blood Sail and Brash Tide.
Yo.
Yo. I'm going to go... Should I go this way? Yeah, I'm going to go this way. I might get rooted, but as long as I stay on my mount, I can avoid it. I think the root comes from a Frost Nova from the mages. So as long as I run by them and they don't get it off, I should be fine. Yeah. Oop. So I'm looking for Grilson. And I passed him. Did I really? I'm going to go up. He must be up. Southern Savage Coast. I do not think that I have been here. I see him on the map. I might just have to jump to him. Oh yeah, there he is. Here we go. And that's how you do that. You go the wrong way and you just kind of jump. Obtain the head of Fleetmaster Seahorn in Booty Bay. Yancey hears things. A few of me hearties were pretty deep in their cups when they told me about some Tauren warrior that came a-rolling through the Southern Command looking for charts and orders. That's me. Even ran a couple of old good pirates through, he did. Like I said, they were up to their eyeballs in grog, but still, a buccaneer's gotta trust his ears, so I've got one small task for you. One sent down from Firulan himself. Bring me the head of Fleetmaster Seahorn. Okay, I'll do that. Where is he? He's in Booty Bay. I had to leave Booty Bay to get a quest to go back to Booty Bay. All right. I get it. There's a lot of that in Classic, so get used to it. Everything is a go somewhere and do something and then come back. And it's usually multiple times. It's usually not just once. The most significant example I can think of, because it's still fresh in my mind, is Duskwood. And Duskwood sends you back and forth between Abercrombie and the inn like four or five times. And it's just to turn in a quest and go back and forth. It's basically go talk to him and hear his story. And then you come back. It's like, okay, go give him this item. And then you go give him these items. Like, okay, go back and talk to him again. And then you start getting quests. It's crazy. When is Classic WoW coming out? Classic WoW is coming out in the summer of 2019. So it is currently January 4th, 2019. So it's going to be this year, unless something terrible happens. And it's anywhere from between late June to late September. I think most people equate summer to when people aren't in school. So they're like, okay, June, July, and August, it's going to be that. But summer actually goes all the way into September. So it could be September, it could be June. We don't really know yet. Looks like a Tauren pirate to me. Oh yeah, I gotta get your head, that's sad. Obtain a cow head and an oversized pirate hat, then bring them back to Fleetmaster Seahorn. Okay, this Yancey character probably doesn't know my face too well. Most non-Tauren find us Tauren indistinguishable from one another. In fact, most non-Tauren find us indistinguishable from a certain four-legged creature. Lol. The Leatherworker keeps one of these creatures here in Booty Bay, and Narek is my chief supplier for the pirate hats. So Yancey wasn't talking about me, he was talking about this guy. So I need to get a bunch of stuff. And who's got it down here? Somebody, right? Oversized pirate hat and cow head. So who's got the pirate hat? I didn't read that part. Head to Zorimgar Outpost on the coast of Zorimstrand. Oh, wait, no, that's Ashenvale. There we go. Leatherwork keeps one of these, and Narek is my chief supplier for pirate hats. Get a replacement. Where's Narek? Or are they all in Booty Bay? Well, let's get out of here, because maybe this is just the circle for completing the quest, not the other items. Yeah, so they're out here. F to Bossy the Cow. I just went and saw him, and... oh, sad. I was just talking about her. Is it below me? Oh, it's below me. Well, let's go up here first. Oh, crap. No, I didn't want to jump here. It's one of those weird places where you can actually get stuck. Urgh. Come on. Yes, there's a path available. I can see it. I can put my circle right on top of it. Ah. All right. I'll start over. Just got your brand new PC build done yesterday. I want to start on it. What'd you build? I love building computers. I love talking about building computers. I miss building this computer. Give me the details. What do you got? Give me the specs.
Hello. Have a good one.
Okay, so are these circles wrong, or what's going on here? I can't fit out this door. I literally cannot exit right here. So these circles have to be wrong. Wait for it.
Interesting. You have a great day now.
What? There's Bossy. Oh, this must be the Bossy one. Bossy, I need to ask something great of you. I need to cut off your head to prove my loyalty to the Bloodsail Buccaneers so they will allow me to infiltrate their ranks and hopefully discover their true intentions. Booty Bay needs you, Bossy, now more than ever. Or moo. Sad.
It was my mistake. Apologies.
What if I chicken out? Nothing. I'm sad. Bossy did nothing wrong. There should have been another way to do that quest. It's very sad. Are you it? Oversized pirate hat. No. Are you it? Pirate supplies. There we go. Ryzen 220G, 3.7 gigahertz and 8 gig of RAM. No dedicated graphics card, but it's integrated with the CPU Vega 8. I think integrated graphics should be fine for classic. It's always ideal to have discrete graphics or dedicated. But if literally all you're doing is playing, you know, classic WoW and you're doing it on the classic settings or even, you know, low settings like 4 or 5, it should be fine. I mean, the problem with video cards right now is they're so damn expensive still. All right, I got everything I needed. Wait, there we go.
Ancestors watch over you.
Wait, what? Hurry up.
How may I aid you? Be careful.
For computer parts, what I do, what I've been doing forever, is whenever I buy a new computer part, I sell old ones just to make it cheaper. What am I in combat with? That was weird. And I finally got a 2080 Ti. It took probably 6 to 8 weeks of waiting for them to get in stock. I got mine from Newegg. But this computer build that I've just finished, it has been a labor of love for going on 6 months, 7 months. And I still haven't put pictures up in Discord. I have to do that this weekend. I'm going to write a post-it note and put it right in front of me saying, post picture of computer. B450 MSI Bazooka motherboard. Not a bad one. MSI makes good stuff. I like MSI. I used to have a couple of their motherboards. I've basically switched to almost exclusively Asus builds for hardware. So I have Asus GPUs and Asus motherboards.
Looking for something specific?
All right, idiot. Bring your papers to Captain Keelhaul. You may be a slayer of fleet masters, but rules is rules and orders is orders. And my orders say that all new pirates start out as swabbies. It's the rule.
Have a good one.
All right, so I'm a swabbie. And now I gotta go down to the pirate ships. Okay, whoa. An entire year to gather parts. Oh yeah, depending on your budget and what you want to do, you can either go really slow just to save money and get deals, or you know, kind of pay as you go as you save up, or wait for something new. And I kind of did a mixture of all three. Literally, the last thing that I bought was the case. You think a Radeon graphics card should be more compatible with AMD? I honestly don't know. I don't think the drivers... Well, yeah, as soon as you pop in a discrete graphics card, you're not going to be doing the AMD switch program, because they can... You usually see that on laptops where you go back and forth between integrated and discrete depending on the program. If you just have discrete in a PC build, you're never going to use the dedicated or the integrated graphics, so you don't have to worry about it. My guess is you can get whatever you want. I'm partial to NVIDIA. I think they have the best graphics cards for gaming, and have for quite a while. But budget-wise, Radeon makes very, very good budget cards that will be acceptable for mid-tier gaming graphics-wise. I mean, it's not like you're going to be pushing max settings, running 4K, running three screens and surround sound or anything. No, you're just playing classic WoW. And if you play something else, a Radeon should be just fine. All right, there's Captain Keyhole. Here's the papers. Slayer of the Great Seahorn, eh? That doesn't matter on my ship. Only thing you're going to be slaying is deck stains. Gross. Pick up a Swabby's mop on the deck of the Riptide, then keep the deck clean for 2 minutes? So I have to clean up shit for 2 minutes, is this quest. I don't think this quest was in Classic. I really, really don't. Pretty Boy Duncan, I remember that. Obtain 6 blood sail cannonballs from the water beneath the Riptide. Okay, but I need to grab a mop and let's see. Now look for stains. Oh, there's a new stain. Gross. But is that corn? That's a skeleton. What the hell? What are these people eating? Those are bones and skeletons? Oh, another stain appeared. These guys have some serious digestion issues. Wait, why aren't they disappearing? You have to click them more than once? It doesn't look like it. So... Well, I'm just going to click once and move. This seems harder than it should be. All right, there's one. Oh, I did it. Yay, go me. Oh, there's another quest to pick up. It's up here. What is it? Gar Salthoof, obtain 5 bushels of limes. Got it. When the game crashes, it's because something in the PC is incompatible, but you can still play it. I think more like not optimized. I think it's a better way of saying it. It could be. I've never had a AMD computer build or an AMD graphics card ever. Is that an upgrade? It is. A nice one too. Sweet. All that for wiping up whatever the hell those guys were eating. So now I have to get some cannonballs and some bushels of lime. So the cannonballs are underneath here, right? That's a shark. What level? 41 non-elite. Why don't I see I don't see anything. Wait. No. Oh, there we go. There's a cannonball. I'm surprised I don't have anything to help me swim underwater. What is this debuff? Physical damage inflicted every 3 seconds. Fair enough. Wow, these things are really few and far between. What is that over there? Nothing. Well, I'm gonna go back up and get some breath. This is nuts. Dude, just go away. Seriously. Can I stun you? Just leave me alone. I really don't want to play with you. Please leave me alone. Good, he evaded. Thank you. You thought Classic WoW was out today? Or by now? I wish. If Classic WoW was already out, God, I'd be in heaven. We've got a good 6 months to go. At least. Where did you come from? I didn't even see you. Are you a respawn? Get off me. So this quest is awful. I don't like underwater quests. I like them even more if you don't get any sort of speed increase. And I like them, I like them even less if you don't get a speed increase. And then even less than less if you don't get an underwater breath mechanic, which I don't have. And I got a mob on me. And I'm dazed. Well, at least I can heal myself and then stun him. Cannonball. I need 2 more of these stupid cannonballs. All right, I'm just going to kill you because I'm so sick of getting dazed by you. You're just an annoyance and you need to die. Time goes so fast. I know, it really does. Before we know it, I'm going to be logging in on my human mage questing in Northshire Valley. Probably choking up, tearing up a little bit, and feeling that I'm actually home. One more cannonball. There's one over there. It's being guarded by a stupid big fish. It's going to be a ton of fun. I mean, it really is. I'm really looking forward to the launch because I want to see how many people actually show up. And because it's tied, I've talked about this so many times before, so I won't go in too much detail, but because it's tied to a Battle for Azeroth subscription, my guess is there's going to be a lot of tourists on the launch day in the first week, because a bunch of people are going to show up and just see what's going on. And that's going to cause some interesting issues, I think. A little bit of trolling, a little bit of server instability, probably the implementation of some temporary sharding mechanisms. But eventually, you know, after a couple of weeks, it's going to die down. And when it does, that's when the real fun begins. Now, it's going to be fun. You know, as soon as the game launches, I'm going to have a blast. It's going to be great. I can't wait. But, you know, once the tourists leave, then, you know, the communities are going to start being built and the names are going to start getting familiar and we're going to get higher into levels. We're going to start getting into our 30s and then we're going to hopefully play the auction house correctly and get our mounts. But it's going to take a while. It's going to be a slow grind. I'm not going to rush. I'm going to be playing a ton, so I'll still be going relatively quickly, especially now since I know what I'm going to be doing. And I'm not going to be sidetracked with quests and whatnot. I'm going to try to stay on a fairly good path. But I'm still not going to be rushing. I'm not going to be 60 in 2 weeks. I'm not going to be 60 in 3 weeks, I don't think. I don't know how long it's going to take for me to get to level 60. I have no plans to get there quickly at all. I think what makes WoW Classic so appealing, other than the fact that I just genuinely believe that it is a better game overall, is that there are no time constraints. None. I don't have to rush because the next tier is coming out, making the current tier obsolete. I don't have to rush because a new expansion is coming out, making everything I'm doing obsolete. I can just play because the game is just the game. Now, they're going to be doing separate phases. They're going to be, you know, phasing in content over time. But I don't think that's going to be so fast that what I'm going to be doing is going to become trivial. Because even when, you know, BWL comes out, it's not like Molten Core suddenly becomes trivial. It doesn't. That's just not how Classic worked. So there's literally nothing to prevent me from getting 10 levels per month or 2 levels per week. Or whatever I want to do, however slow I want to go. Now, obviously, I'm going to go a lot faster than that, a lot. But the point is, I can get level 60 over 2 months and not care. Will I be part of the server-first Molten Core? No. Do I care? Not even a little. I'm not playing Classic WoW to try to get realm-first raids and then quit. I'm playing it to relive the journey and do all of the quests and do all of the farming and just experience what the gameplay was like, what the community building was like, what playing with guilds was like, what doing actually difficult quests was like, all of that stuff. You know, that is why I'm playing Classic. Not to rush to 60 in 4 days and try to clear Molten Core in 10 days. I don't see any fun in that. I need 2 more bushels of limes, and it says it's only available in this very small portion of the map. I don't know if that's accurate, so I'm going to go down to the other trees and see if there's any more. My guess is there is, but, you know, who knows? Well, there's some over by the ships I can see. So maybe I'll go back that way. I'll just do one pass all the way down there quick, and then I'll head back to the ships. Pretty much a brand new player, only tried the trial and didn't even do a day's worth of gaming on it. What trial? Like the original trial for Classic or the trial for a certain expansion? Because obviously the game has gone through significant changes and iterations basically since Wrath of the Lich King. Well, I'm going to head back to the ships. Because this is no good. There's 2 trees over there, so I'm guessing the bushels of lime have something to do with palm trees for some reason. Original. Oh, perfect. I just can't wait to see how many people come back. You know, a lot of my real friends that played are coming back. Now, I don't know how long they're going to stay, but they're going to come back and try it out. Is there one over here? Oh, sweet. Good. So I'll grab this one, and there's one over by the tree there as well. For me, getting on, getting hooked on World of Warcraft was a very quick proposition. I watched the opening cinematic. I went to the character creation screen after spending probably 3 days trying to think up a name. I typed in my name. I made my character. I logged in. I watched the human intro. And then I spawned in Northshire Valley. And the forest music started playing. I was immediately hooked. That's literally all it took. You're a new player joining your community. Well, that's awesome. I love when new players show up. Absolutely love it. WoW is going through a little bit of a difficult time right now in terms of, I think there's a lot more perceived negativity than there is actual negativity in terms of what's really going on at Blizzard. But, you know, I mean, that's just how things always are. People kind of assume the worst, even if it's not as bad as they think it is. And that's kind of where Blizzard's at. They have not had a great 2018. The launch of Battle for Azeroth was great, but some of the things that have been going on have hurt their brand. And hopefully they do Classic right. And we can move on from this nonsense. And hopefully 2019 is better. Now, don't get me wrong. To me, Battle for Azeroth is a lot of fun. I'm having a ton of fun with this game. A lot of gripes that people have with the game are not something that I necessarily care about because, quite frankly, I'm not doing Mythic Pluses. I'm not doing Mythic Rating. So yeah, you can see why, from my viewpoint, for me personally, I don't really have a whole lot of issues with Blizzard right now. But that doesn't mean there are not legitimate issues that people have. But Blizzard's a smart company. They know their brand. They know their player base. They don't want to screw it up. What can I do for you? They will do what needs to be done to fix it. So I need hit smiling Timmy Sticks with a cannonball. That wasn't this guy, was it? No, that was just some random dude. So where is this dude? Is he up top? He must be. Where do I get cannonballs? Oh, right here. Oh, cool. Wait, what is this? Lock on and fire and... Okay, so load. What? No. Oh, man. Oh, this is so slow. Global cooldown. Oh, turn left. What? I missed? What? What is happening? Why is that not hitting him? It's... Oh, my depth perception is way off. Derp. Now that I have the depth perception worked out, it makes this quest a lot easier. Oh, I can get out of here. Exits. Oh, shoot. What is this? Kill 15 ninjas on the aisle. Oh, so I have to go out to this aisle. Okay. I've already been there and done a bunch of quests, so let's go. They've been doing some anti-public things? They have. They definitely have. I'm focusing more on their games and their gameplay. Diablo Immortal, that's a big one. That was a big screw up. It really was. If they would have done it alongside Diablo 4, like if they would have announced Diablo 4 in any way, shape, or form, showed a picture, a screenshot, a small cinematic that had nothing to do with gameplay and just did that, and then they came out and said, but wait, there's more. There's a mobile version of Diablo called Diablo Immortal to tie you over while we finish Diablo 4. That would have gone a long way in making the Diablo community happy. A lot of other stuff. The microtransactions of Diablo Immortal are really getting to people. The game shop is really starting to get to people with mounts. I think the mounts are still on a deep discount sale. Yeah, the See You Later bundle, this is kind of dumb. I bought it, but, you know, to each their own. Wait a minute. Oh, wait, because I haven't... I bought it on my main account. But yeah, all of these are half off. There's just some things that they're doing that seem somewhat desperate, and it seems like decisions are being made from the comptroller and the finance department instead of J. Allen Brack and the development team. And that's a big issue. They need to make sure that the decisions about the game, the direction of the game, what's important, what goes in, what goes out, what systems get implemented, that has to stick with the developers. And so long as they do that, they will weather this shitstorm that they're in right now. I honestly believe that. If they let finances get in too paramount to what they're doing, then they're in trouble. Because they are going through a cost-cutting phase right now, which is, you know, that's just a sign of the times. It really is. I mean, you had Apple come out two nights ago and revise their earnings downward based on tariffs, foreign trade policy, and lack of growth and demand in China. And, you know, if Apple is doing that, that means that their iPhone sales are down, which directly correlates to mobile games, which is what Blizzard is trying to do with Diablo Immortal. They're specifically making mobile games to tap further into the Chinese market where mobile sales are going down. So it's a very, very interesting give and take that we're about to see. Is their bet going to pay off? I hope so. Because I don't want them to cut costs and cut development teams from World of Warcraft. I really don't. They just cut Heroes of the Storm, but that IP was struggling in and of its own. It could just never get into the MOBA market. It really couldn't. You know what? I haven't seen a single ninja yet. Do I have to do something different? Summon Deadeye. Oh. Ah, okay. Now what? Are you going to show me where these people are? Oh, there's a ninja. There's a big... All right, let's do this. I'm going to pull this guy. Come here. Come on. Come on. Come on. And there we go. I think what I'm concerned with the most is that MAUs for Blizzard continues to decline in World of Warcraft because people are fed up with the BS systems that they perceive are in the game, and the game is not fun or to their liking anymore. And if enough people start jumping ship because Blizzard just will not listen to the player base and significantly alter what they're doing and how they're doing it, then I could see an instance where Activision says, all right, Blizzard, it's time to ramp down development costs on World of Warcraft. Yeah, we're going to still make new expansions. Yeah, we're still going to make new content. It's just going to come out much, much slower because you are hemorrhaging money on things that people refuse to play. Now, I say hemorrhaging money loosely. They're not hemorrhaging money. I mean, World of Warcraft is still a cash cow for them, and it will be as long as there's, you know, millions of subscribers. But they have to do the right thing and take care of their community. They don't have to cater to every single person and, you know, listen to every single bit of criticism and fix every single thing that people say is wrong. But if people are unhappy with the mechanics that the game is built on, then they need to change the mechanics the game is built on. You know, I've been unhappy with those mechanics since basically mid Wrath of the Lich King and then starting in Cataclysm. I just think the mechanics on what the game was built on changed significantly. And it was just no longer the same feel as World of Warcraft as I remember it. Which is one of the reasons I'm so looking forward to Classic, because that is the original game mechanic. That is how an MMO should be. That's how an MMO should play. And that's the game that I want to play. For the Lich King. Wrath of the Lich King was a very good expansion. It really was. The quests were great. The zones were great. The music was great. The lore being in-depth. I mean, we saw our first in-game cutscenes used to a significant degree. There were a couple in Sunwell, but not like Not like Wrath of the Lich King. I mean, you had the Wrathgate, for God's sakes. What is hitting me? What? Alright. Let's see. Let me kill you. Let me heal up. I was not paying attention to that. Anyway, overall, Wrath was a great expansion. It failed for me. I shouldn't say failed. It didn't live up to my expectations as if they matter, because that's when they instituted systems that turned WoW into a completely different game. That's where we got the foray into multiple difficulties of raids. That's when we got looking for group. It's what led to LFR. It started leading to more accessible content. And that basically led us to where we are now. And I still play Battle for Azeroth, obviously. I think it's a fun expansion. I think there's a lot of different things to do. I think World of Warcraft and the Burning Crusade are better. I would play them more than I would Battle for Azeroth. If they were not releasing Classic, I would still play Battle for Azeroth. I would play it in my own unique way, doing the things that I want to do in game. And I would play the next expansion and the expansion after that. It would take a lot for them to get me to say, you know what, I'm done with your game. You hope the Lich King is brought back. Well, the Lich King is still there. The Lich King right now is Bulvar. But I think you mean Arthas. I don't know if they can bring Arthas back. That's one of those things where killing Arthas had to be pretty much permanent for the lore to make sense. I mean, it's not like Ragnaros, where we kill him in Classic, but we just, you know, push him back into the Twisting Nether, and he can be summoned again. But we did kill him in Cataclysm, when he fully emerged from the Twisted Nether and had feet, and then we killed him. Same thing with Kil'jaeden the first time around. We just pushed him back into the Twisted Nether. Or Twisting Nether. All right, there's two ninjas. I'm going to get one of them. Spoilers? I can't really spoil something that happened 10 years ago, can I? I mean, there's got to be a statute of limitations on when the term spoiler actually applies. The Horde needs a real war chief? Yeah, they really do. Well, the Lich King, you're not going to see him anywhere in Classic WoW. Do I need any of these? No. Shoulders, it's not an upgrade. What else do I need? I just got another quest. I thought I did. No, I didn't. Well, I have to go get 75 oil. I hit level 73. How do I slay 75 oil workers? What? Hold on. Let me kill this thing while I read this quest. Now that you know how to handle our cannons, it's time to hit some real targets. The Venture Company has found gold to the north of here, a rare type called black gold. More like a black spot, if you ask me. We're going to take the gold, but first we need to get rid of those Venture Company goons. I've gotten an... Okay, so. There's obviously cannons for me to use. All right. So where are these cannons? Head off the ship down the gangplank and speak. Oh no. Well, I had to go to this isle anyway to do this quest. The person I talked to do this quest is actually back by the ship. So that's not a big deal. I had to go to this isle to do this quest. So we're good. Now I will just go back to the ship and finish the quest. So on tonight's stream, this is Friday afternoon. Tonight when I get back online, we're going to be doing something totally fun and engaging that everybody wants to do. I'm going back to Legion to do world quests and achievements. It's going to be part of what I'm doing tonight. I did a little bit of that this afternoon just to see what the world quests were like, if I could one-shot everything, how difficult the achievements were, yada, yada, yada. And I got quite a few done. I think I finished 3 zones of world quest so far. And I think I'm going to finish the Pillars of Creation quest line. If you remember that from, 2 years ago, you had the Pillars of Creation, and every time you finished the legendary quest, you went into the middle of Dalaran, and it appeared on the wall, and stuff happened. I never finished that, because I didn't really play Legion. Alright, so where is this person? Oh, it's the other ship, isn't it? I went to the wrong ship. It's over there. Is it over there? Hold on. I've got an oarsman who will take you out there. Head off the ship down the aisle. So I'm looking for a boat. Ah, there he is.
What can I do for you?
Ahoy, matey. Hoist anchor, trim the mainsail, batten down the hatches, and set to sea. Today we scuttle the Venture Company blasted contraptions and send them to all... So you can do this big, elaborate RP stuff, or you can just say, I need a boat. And, dude, I need a boat. This guy oars really fast through the wood. All right, so I'm looking to lock onto something. I don't know what. I don't see anything to lock onto right now. There's nothing. Oh, wait. Here we go. Did I miss one? Oh, I missed you right there. And you right there. Okay, so you have to kill them all, and then he automatically goes to the next one. And then once you're done, you ask him to go back. Oh, I get it. Oh, there's guys up there. So these guys are installing guard railings. So they're putting in safety measures. So let's... Am I locked down or something? Oh, I was. So let's kill these guys putting in safety harness or safety measures. Got those guys. Wow, this is very weird collision. Oh, locked on. That's hilarious. I wonder why they make it so that you have to be underwater to see where you're aiming. It's just very, very weird design. Okay, we got all of them. Anybody left? Oh, yeah, there's one guy there. Let's grab him. Okay. A very slow quest. Let's see, how long have I been going? I've been going for an hour? No way. Wow. Time flies. Dude, stop right here. Right here. No, stop. Stop. Oh, this is perfect. Just stop. Please stop. Thank you. All right. These are the last ones that I need. And then I can return. And we're good. Okay. No. Oh, no. What? I didn't get... Oh, crap. Fire. Oh, no. Please hit somebody. Oh, my God. How did that only kill 2 people? That's so weird. Ugh. Annoying quest. Oh, God. I need a boat again because I failed. I'm stupid. LOL fail? Yeah. Epic fail. I can't wait to see what Stranglethorn was like in Classic. I remember bits and pieces. I don't remember what was going on down here. I don't remember what was going on other than the book quest and the farming quests. Everything in Booty Bay, I have very, very... But there we go. I have very little memory of what was going on in this zone. None of this stuff was here because there were no goblins and cataclysm. This boss on the outskirts was, but he was an elite. I just saw him. Well, he patrols back there somewhere. So it'll be interesting to see what it's like. This quest was not there. That I know. Yay, I did it. What next? I am 2 of 4 chapters. So what is the 4th chapter? Blood Sail and Bashtide. Up or down? Down. No music on the boat? Wait, you're in here, right? Yep, Iron Patch. There you are. Choose my reward, a shield that I'll never use, or plate shoulders that have 10 parries. So these are tanking shoulders. I'm not a tank. I am a DPS.
You need something?
The Damsel's Luck. I know you just arrived here on the Crimson Veil, but I need to send you off on another task. The Damsel's Luck is the 3rd ship in my fleet, moored over to the east. Her skipper, Captain Stillwater, is no longer with us. Damn those masked hoodlums. Anyhow, Iron Patch told me about your heroics at sea, and I'd be running low on quality brigands. I think you're more than capable for this new duty.
See you later.
All right. Let's go see what it is. Music reminds you of Dark Souls. I've actually never played Dark Souls. I bought a PS4 a number of years ago, and Dark Souls 3 came with it, and I didn't really play it. Although people are starting to stream Dark Souls and Dark Souls 3 lately, because Asmongold started doing it. I've watched him play a couple times. It looks like I can't really figure out the game, right? I've heard that it's amazing. People love it. But to me, it looks like you have a couple abilities, which is just swing and hit. And the people you go against have a few abilities where they swing and hit. And if you jump out of the way and dodge, you can win. Which, I don't know. I'm being overly general. I mean, I know there's a lot more to it than that. It's just what it seems like. So what do I have to do? Do I have to talk to you? Try it out. The lore is almost I like hidden lore like that. Oh, you guys are, okay, I wasn't expecting this, so let me get some sweeping strikes. Die by the sword, right? Yeah, die by the sword, all that good stuff. I'm disarmed. Oh, we can't have that. It won't hold your hand. I do like that when a game does not hold your hand and just kind of puts you in there and says, all right, go nuts. Kind of a trial by fire, right? Sink or swim.
Hey there, for the Alliance.
Cuphead was kind of that way. It wasn't a difficult game in terms of not knowing what to do, but it was one of those games where you had to die and die often to learn how to play. It's kind of one of my favorite games on the Super NES, Ghosts and Goblins. Similar thing. So, let's see. Talk to people out here. Oh, I can't. It must be only people down below. Prepare to Die Edition. I like the sound of that. But what am I missing here?
Greetings.
Oh, there's a guy.
You need something?
I do.
See you later. Can I help you?
Keep your chin up, eh?
Sabotage the gunpowder, the grog, and the cannonballs. Okay, so where are the cannonballs? Up here? Sword vendor? I don't need any of this. I can get rid of all of this. I don't need any of it. Okay. What am I missing? Where are the cannonballs? Were they down below and I just didn't see them? Is that what happened? Well, another guy to kill, so that's good. Wait, didn't I already do this? Yeah, I already did that. All right, we got to go on a fishing expedition and see where this stuff is. It's not on this level. Maybe it's...
Greetings. What can I do for
we
you?
We already talked to him. Careful. I'm confused. I'm very confused. Are they up at... Oh, maybe they're up at the helm of the ship. Let me try that. Did not look there. Nope. Okay. Oh, it's other ships. The attack on Booty Bay is looming. You'll have to return to Booty Bay quickly and inform Baron. First, however, it might be a good idea to sabotage some of the pirates' supplies while you're still in their favor. The pirates keep most of their supplies below decks, spread out across the entire fleet. So, hey, idiot, read the quest text. The reason that there was still blue circles on that ship is because I'm 5 of 9 on the Bloodsail Corsair accused and killed. The other 4 things I need to do are 2 on this ship and 2 on that ship. First time in Stormwind. Wow. I'm actually jealous of you. I remember the first time I entered Stormwind. I was on my human mage and I had next to no gear. I was level maybe 5 or 6 at best.
You got my attention.
And the first thing that I remember is because view distance was not very big in the game back then. You couldn't see very far ahead of you. So the walls of Stormwind just come out of nowhere. And then as soon as you pass under the stone arc, the gate, and you're standing on the stone, it says discover Stormwind, and the music starts. And I will never forget the first time that I heard the Stormwind music. It was just incredible. It felt like nothing I'd ever felt in a video game before.
Hey there, have a good one.
I'm gonna take both of you on. Oh, you're a guy I had to talk to. I'm disarmed. Smashing buttons. I'm just gonna kill the last two right here. Then I will know exactly where to go on the other ship.
Can I help you? See you later.
Last one. Did he parry that? No way. Oh no, it hit him, just not for very much. Making Mutineer's Noose. Ooh. The few Bloodsail Buccaneers that Booty Bay has to fight, the better. However, it might be best to stop slaughtering your supposed allies before you draw suspicion on yourself. Good plan. All right, now I have to go to the other ship. Hey guys, don't mind me. I wasn't killing anybody. I was just hanging out. And we go. You wish it was more open. Stormwind is actually fairly open, but it's separated into different districts. It's not like Ironforge, though. If you're looking for open like Ironforge, you're not going to find it. Are these an upgrade? Yeah, they are. Nice one, too.
Greetings. For the Alliance.
Well met. Need help? See you around.
Sabotage the cannonballs. All right. Cannonballs. They must be below. All the way below. Orgrimmar is very open too, but I don't have a lot of experience in Orgrimmar because I was basically a Alliance player and only an Alliance player. Okay, so no cannonballs down here. All right, back up top. Cannonballs. Hello? What? The quest said they keep them below. You have your mop. Now look for stains to swab. Oh, somebody must be doing that quest. Am I blind? Ah, there it is. I'm sort of blind. Grease the cannonballs. That's funny. And report to Baron at Booty Bay in the Cape. I'm at Hearth. So we will see what happens here. Oh yeah, he's outside, but on the third level. Second level and third level. All right, what happened? That absolutely makes sense, and it's not good news either. The Brash Tide are formidable foes, and if their numbers are anywhere near what they were before they disappeared, we're in for a nasty battle. Even with all of my suspicions about Firulan's plot, we aren't prepared for a full two-front attack between the Bloodsail and the Brash Tide. It's going to take a small miracle to hold Booty Bay. All right, I need to find a barrel of double rum. Where do I get a barrel of double rum? Probably the bartender? In his chambers. Take the stairs down three flights and check the first floor. All right, we'll just go down. No, it's a chair. Okay. The first door on your right. Oh, there it is. I don't know why my entire screen is shaking. Bring the double rum back, okay? So I went and did what you commanded.
I have work for once.
Whoa! They're here. Holy cow. Prepare for takeoff. Seeking Seahorn. Obtain Nox Headmaster. Blah, 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 blah. Let's do this quick. Seeking Seahorn. Report to Fleetmaster Seahorn in Booty Bay. He's what? Down there? Okay. That big ship behind you. Kill 8 Corsairs in Booty Bay. And 10 Raiders. Okay. Let's get on this rope. Yeah! Cool! Sweet! Everybody's already dead. No. Hey, buddy. I'ma kill you. Oh, see you, Gundam. I did not even, I didn't see you take off. My bad. I hope you're still here. But if not, we'll see you anyway. You're not gonna hear it. There we go. I'm just gonna load everything on these two guys. I don't like being disarmed. I feel so- ooh, there's a person right in here. Did I get credit? No, it's an Alliance scum. I'm stuck in that door. That's so funny. Sorry, Alliance. That's my mob. Oh, here we go. Double execute. Just before the disarm. Oh no, I'm disarmed before the execute. Lame. Doge House, good to see you again. I can't kill either of those people and get credit, so... I'm really confused. What the hell? That was interesting. I got two weird noises like I was locking up, but I wasn't locked up. I just wasn't paying attention to my health. Yeah, I didn't look at my health a single time. Oh, how am I going to get to the boat? Uh-oh. I'm going to have to go underneath the boat. I don't know why, but I never pay attention to my health when I'm on the warrior. Can I get close enough to resurrect? That is the question. Can I wall jump onto the boat? That's another one. Nope. All right, let's do this again and pay attention to my health. Oh yeah, I gotta kill 10 of these guys. But the hand bombs are... I'm gonna go on the ship first. The hand bombs are not on the ship, right? Yeah, they're not. All right, paying more attention to what I'm doing now, this should go a lot easier. Oh, this is definitely good. Definitely good music. On your mage, you're either 100% or dead. That's basically how I play a mage. Wow, I'm saving this person's life and I don't need to. They were AFK. Actually, they look bugged out. Oh well. Alright, so let's go back and kill the raiders. Wow, these guys go down really fast. I think it's because other people are attacking them and NPCs, so that always helps. Yep. All right, where is this dude? Looking for hand bombs. The Alliance player right next to me leveled up.
I got the best deal anywhere.
Wait a minute. Narc's hand bombs. Well, there's Narc. Oh, it's in that crate. Derp. You found a streamer that started playing the game for the very first time. That is cool. I always like seeing people play this game for the first time and get their honest thoughts. If I started playing the game right now, I have no idea what I would think of it because it's not even a hint of the game it used to be. That's not to say the game is not fun. If it wasn't fun, I wouldn't play it. It's just their experience is playing the game for the first time is going to be completely different than my experience playing for the first time. All right, we've done everything. Let's go turn in the quests. Really? Really, dude? You want to do that? Oh, I don't turn it into him. I turn him in... Oh, it's up there. So I gotta go back in and go up to, I think his name is Razik or something like that. He equipped a gun and was wondering why he couldn't fight anymore. I laugh, but I mean, I did ridiculously stupid things when I first started playing the game because I had no idea what to do or how to do it either.
Keep your nose clean in my town.
All right, the final voyage. 85 Brash Tide crewmen slain, 6 Brash Tide attack boat destroyed. Okay, so I clearly have to get into guns somewhere. Where do I do this? Let's read. Bring a couple armloads of hand bombs with you. You'll need to blah, 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 blah. Okay. Wait, way over there? Really? Hold on. The Horde Flightmaster's assistant is right around the corner. Talk to him. Okay.
Speak, friend.
Sorry, not here to chat. I need a Windrider to take me on a special mission. Okay, here we go. I think one of the dumbest things that I've done playing the game, like my first noob moment, was I didn't use a single talent point until I was level like 16 or 17 in Red Ridge Mountains, because I could not figure out why the dragon whelps were killing me so fast and why I couldn't do hardly any damage to them. Because I was using Fireball and Frostbolt rank 1. So they got a lot more ships than the 3 that we saw out in port. I wonder where these all came from. Those guys are Jesus. They're walking on the water. Good for them. Oh, there's a boat right there. No, come back. That's the boat I wanted to destroy. You didn't enter another dungeon until you were level 60. I could see that because the game had so much stuff to do in questing, even in Kata. Level 15 with my first character, I signed up as a healer. God, I got roasted with my teammates. Yeah. Wrath is basically around the time when it started to, Looking for Group and LFR was basically the advent of, if you don't know how to play your class and you do bad as a healer or bad as a tank, you're stupid and you should quit. And that turned off a lot of people. It made them avoid certain things like what you did is not queue for dungeons. The community was very, very toxic in-game for quite a while. I don't get the sense that it's like that anymore. It could be, but I don't see it very often in trade chat anymore. I really don't. Speak with Kabok in Booty Bay to get a Windrider, then kill Fleet Master Ferelon. All right. So we got to go back, and we're going to fly somewhere and kill him. It was bad until late mop. I could see that. I liked mop. Dog is barking at something. All right, where is this captain guy? He must be down below. Yoink. When WoW and Legion drew in massive amounts of new players and returns, the atmosphere's changed. It is much more noob friendly now. Yeah. The game has become a lot more accessible, and it's drew in a lot of newer players as more veteran players and older players quit because of, you know, they don't like the direction of the game or they don't like the expansion or whatever reason. But there seems to be a lot more people that don't exactly know what they're doing, like there used to be. Did somebody just kill him? Because he's not here. Unless I missed him, which I could have missed him. Wait, did I go this way at all? I didn't. Get one more stack. I'll just hit him now with overpower. I was gonna try to get two stacks of overpower, but didn't really work. There we go. Execute. Boom. All right. So, whoa, what's this? Squawky Jr. What? Hello? Huh? What was that? That was weird. Okay. Yikes. Is the boat gone? The boat's gone. Nice. Booty Bay Helm. You're awake.
I am.
We found you bobbing in the harbor shortly after the remaining attackers had turned tail. We were worried about you for a while there. I've been meaning to thank you. Not only did you provide us with the intelligence to prepare for this attack, but you helped fight off the Blood Sail and the Brash Tide. Your name will always be remembered here in Booty Bay. We here in Booty Bay pride ourselves on our booty. Care to take first pick?
Lol.
There we go. Cape of Stranglethorn complete. Blood Sail and Brash Tide. So what is this? A helm that is actually pretty good. 12 crit. And what is this? Star of Stranglethorn. Held in the offhand. I'll keep it because it's an offhand. But wait. Stamina and haste? I don't know if I need... I'm just going to sell it. I actually don't need that for anything. And I don't need anything else either. Well, wow. Go me. So I think in Orgrimmar...
Yeah, what do you want?
Or in Booty Bay, I think I can get to Orgrimmar, right?
Keep it real.
Northern Barrens... Oh, I just have to go to Gromgol. Okay.
I got what you...
I'm going to do that and just go to the auction house and do some stuff. But, wait a minute. Isn't there an auction house here? Oh, there used to be, but there's not anymore. Let me check and make sure. Oh, there is an auction house. Good. All right. Well, I'm going to end the YouTube episode here, and then I'm going to do a couple cleanup things with the bags and whatnot after. So, we finished the Cape, we finished Northern Stranglethorn, so we are done. We are level 43? 44, we just hit 44, I didn't even see that actually. So, next on my list is figure out where I'm gonna level next. I don't know. No idea. Northern Stranglethorn. Oh yeah, I still have to, I'm going to do that as well. Anyway, before the start of the next episode, I'm going to figure out where to go in the next one. Don't know as far as zones. We'll figure it out. We have 16 levels to go before we start the next series. We probably should be able to do 2 or 3 more zones. We'll see how that goes. But that's the end of today on YouTube. Thanks for hanging out. We'll check you in the next one.